afternoon, everybody. Sorry about that. I was just put to sleep by these cats, which you can see are doing what cats do very best, and that is, of course, absolutely nothing. Welcome on our live safari. I do apologize if I offended any of you with that start. I thought I was being rather amusing, didn't you, Brian?
I enjoyed it.
Thank you so much, Brian. Brian is on camera today, and he has a special guest on the thumb today. Who's that, Brian?
Pinchy Weiner.
And it's Pinchy Weiner, the crab, the freshwater crab, no longer resident. Well, we don't know where he's resident. He could still be in his old hole. He might have moved. Very nice, Brian. Excellent. We've come to these lions. We knew they were going to be asleep, of course, because lions sleep during the middle of the day, and they will move around probably as it gets a bit cooler during the night. 23 degrees Celsius, which is roughly 74 degrees Fahrenheit, if I'm not mistaken. So quite a warm day for the middle of winter, and these lions are luxuriating in the shade of the winter woodland. As you can see, he did look up briefly as we came in here, but then went straight back to sleep. And so we'll have a look at him quickly, and then we'll have a look at the females just down the way. Only three of them, and I'm interested as to where the other two are. The one certainly was with her little babies this morning, and we're going to head off that way and see if we can have a look at them this afternoon. The other one, I suspect, also with those other three little cubs, but where they are, we don't know. Quite near the camp, we had some bushbuck alarm calling earlier, and we thought we might find the little cubs and their mother somewhere around there. We did have a brief look around before we came up here, but they were not around. So that's the case here. We are as live as Jamie is, believe it or not, even though I started off this show fast asleep. Do talk to us, hashtag Safari Live or questions at wildearth.tv. It'd be lovely to hear from you, and especially if things get a little quiet on the animal front. It's always nice to spark some conversations about Africa, conservation, and many issues that you might want to talk about regarding conservation and the African wilderness. Well, we'd be happy to try and address those as we go along. Also, I know there has been quite a lot of query about going to visit those little cubs, which are now, there we go, huge action. You see that, Brian? I think a stick snapped nearby, which got a fright. I'm going to roll forward. There have been quite a lot of queries about us going to see those little cubs, which are now probably only about, 14 days old or so. And a lot of you wondering whether that's sensitive or not, or whether we should be viewing cubs that age or not. And I'll go through that as we drive there, because it's important you understand that we're being as sensitive as we possibly can.